trot without a clear understanding of what you're trying to achieve. Those great New Zealand teams we saw ahead of them, they definitely had that. Reuben Keane's going to be in charge of this one, which could be a little bit of history.
Well, Reuben Keane's second match on the series. Big moment for him to be in charge of this uber-talented South African side and a Canadian team that has a number of debutants, a number of players fresh on their journey to become World Series greats.
Okay, we're good.
Salvin David, a guy who looks like he's playing a different game to everybody else sometimes. Such is the magic in his fingertips, in his boots. Gets us underway with a switch play from the kickoff, and he finds green pastures in the Canadian backfield. The Canucks pressed back deep in their 22 early and giving up a penalty.
Benning Prevot takes it in, but the arriving support off their feet. And this is that clinical play. They set it up. They know exactly what the call is. Put the right men in the right roles and see what the green and gold can do here.
Impi Vissa on the ball. Interesting to see what South Africa do. Ronald Brown, the try machine. JC Pretorius, the man we picked out. Just absorbs a tackle from Canada. Ooh, a bit of a ropey pass to Mr. Milkshake on the touchline. And not quite going to plan for South Africa from that set play.
Well, credit Brock Webster there. You see he's going to throw the ball in. Did really well to make that initial tackle. Man, he's just been playing in Major League Rugby in the States and Canada for Toronto Arrows. He's back in the Sevens jersey.
Well, speaking of Arrows, here's one sails straight into the hands of his jumper.
Leave his arm. In the air.
But taken out in the air. Penalty to Canada. A nice bit of relieving penalty pressure mentioned there of their title in 2017, a day that will live long in the memory of Canadian Sevens rugby fans.
Well, as I said, Nate Hiriam is in the building, as you see Brock Webster, the man from the Oshawa Vikings in Ontario. Nate Hiriam was the only man standing. Phil Mack, who's been a huge hero in the Canadian Sevens scene, is now coaching a lot of these players. He's the development coach. So a lot of these players coming through get the benefit of his experience.
Well, the lineout functioning nicely for Canada, and they get it out to the centres, but they're swarmed by the South African defence, who miss one, and Canada slide through. Lovely show and wrap round the bat. Drops the hammer. Is he going to make it? Ronald Brown isn't even fast enough for this guy. What a try. What a start from Canada, and they love it.
Wow, what a start. Brennick Prevost starts it. Doesn't look like there's much on here, just gets the feet moving, shows the ball, and all of a sudden he's through. He's got a great presence around. He's been off the last couple of series, missed the last two events. And then David Richard returning to the side. Again, an Ontario boy from Mississauga Blues. He takes the pass, and he uses all of his width here up against the speedy Ronald Brown. But he has just enough to delight the Canadian fans.
Well, the conversion goes wide, but I tell you what, it takes a man with a bit of petrol in his tank to outgas Ronald Brown, and he did just that, returning from injury. Did himself a mischief in a 15-a-side game against Portugal. And boy, the Canadians pleased to have him back if he's going to be running in tries like that. But that momentum from the try is given up immediately. Kickoff goes straight out, and South Africa will be patient as they launch a play from the center of the field.
Yeah, so crucial. Prevot comfortable on left and right foot, not unlike Nathan Hiriama. That one overcooked with the left boot. So South Africa set piece midfield.
What a skill.
They're not going to panic here. Yeah.
Yes.
They're always so measured, so measured. Ronald Brown this time invites the Canadian defense onto him. South Africa looking for an opening on the right hand side. Tackles fall off.
High tackle. Yeah.
No time for advantage. Ronald Brown back asking questions. Big long ball over the top. Impi Viss is a big man, but he's got the hands as well. Oh, my goodness. Confrontational stuff out wide on the left. Salvin David, he's going to dance. He's going to pirouette. He's going to keep pumping, and he's still going. 1 meter shy. South Africa numbers to the right. They drop it to the boot for the cross field. And JC Pretorius, wouldn't you know it, the man who doesn't make mistakes, doesn't fluff his lines, and tumbles over the line.
Well, if that doesn't sum up Blitzbach rugby under Coach Neil Powell, there is the full range of skills keeping the ball alive. Then some amazing strength as the tackles come in from the Canadians. Great footwork. And then the kick pass, not too high, nice and flat. So JC Pretorius takes it in stride. Gets the Blitzbach level.
No dice from the boot of Ronald Brown, but JC Pretorius, who is fast, earning a reputation as one of the most feared men on the series. Gets his try scoring campaign off to a start nice and early at the HSBC Singapore Sevens.
That's a hanging kick, difficult for Canada to deal with and stay on the park.
Wow, they do incredibly well, so tight to the touchline, under the attentions of the try scorer Pretorius. Good play from Canada there. Oh, inviting the South African defenders, and the pass was good, but missed with a big chunk of green grass to run into. There we go, Salvin David, king of the assist. Justin Heddle, unfortunately, injured in the Spanish leg. 19 assists between them. When you're playing against a team like that, Gareth, what way do you look for players to shut down?
Yeah, 28 years old. He's been around some of the greatest sevens players.
Wait for me.
He's even on the tries list. He can serve, but he can also score.
Bind! Set!
Scrum 22 meters out. David has to look for himself. He dishes it back, and then they cross over. They put the boot through. No sweeper in place.
Well, how easy is that? Sheikh Soyuzwafi will eat that up all day. No sweeper, green grass, and a lightning winger to charge on to dot down.
Well, these teams do their research. They don't spend their week in the hotel doing nothing, watching Netflix. They do their research, and they've spotted a gap there in the Canadian scrum defense. They don't have a sweeper in play. And again, the skills are executed so they can punish the team.
This time the kick goes over, the try maximized, and South Africa leading Canada 12 points to 5. Seconds remaining. A chance for Canada to fight back, or an opportunity for South Africa to imprint their dominance just that little bit more.
That same hanging kick just inside Canada's 22, gathered by Phil Burnett, the captain.
And again, the chase exerts so much pressure. Canada give that penalty away.
Stop. You need to let him get up, get back 10.
And Impi Visser, a man in a hurry to get the ball, but South Africa not in a hurry to play the ball, are they?
Well, they will see this as an opportunity, though, 20 meters out.
Down. Let's go now.
Another chip over the top, looking to create a bit of chaos behind that back
leave
line.
Leave it!
With the referee communicating hands off, and they can get this off the field, Canada, and restart.
Well, sweet relief for Canada at the end, under huge amounts of pressure from South Africa, but they are well within the fight. They trail by just 7, South Africa 12, Canada 5. So half time, and South Africa in the position they need to be in.
They started well that first try of the match.
Okay. We're good? All right, we're good.
Okay. We're all waiting for each other here. So a big second half coming up.
Well, it's a young Canadian team, and it's a team that deserves to play without fear because they're young. They're just starting their sevens journey, but it is a South African team that is to be feared because of how good they are.
Yeah, no player over 25. Actually won yesterday, birthday. Congratulations to Phil Burnett, turned 26. The rest of them, 21. And that is the dominance of South Africa on the series right now.
65 points between these two nations on the series at the moment. And South Africa looking to extend their 7-point lead that they took in after the halftime break. An errant pass turns South Africa around. Lovu just caught on the spin, on the hop. The winger born in Standerton. A few tries to his name, but he's going to find it tough to score them when he's got his back to the try line trying to scoop one up off his bootstraps.
True North, strong and free there for Seb, the assistant to Henry Paul.
Find.
He's got a very young side they've been working with. Lots of good experience. They're up to their home tournament next week. Let's see what that can inspire.
BC Place in Vancouver will be jumping, I can assure you that. One of the best rounds on the series, hosted by the men in red, who are toiling admirably against this South African team at the moment. Trailing by 7, in possession, looking to make their mark in the second half early. Heard Neil Powell in the halftime break asking his South African team to slow things down, but the Canadians want to speed it up with lively handling like that.
It's a good play from Canada, asking a few questions up the middle.
A rib tickler tossed up.
Oh, what a pass.
It was a miracle ball, and Phil Berner was wrapping around. Gosh, if he could have just held on to it. And there's Neil Powell. That's his record. That was the man we were speaking about and how influential his absence was in the Olympics. But what he has done for South African sevens, well, as a player, but as a coach too.
I believe their last loss was to Canada up in Vancouver just 2 days before the whole world changed and this little pandemic started in 2020.
Speaking of atmospheres, I thought the roof was going to blow off BC Place when Canada beat South Africa in that bronze medal match. It was electric.
And that was one of the goals of giving them their home tournament. Canada's still in this, only a try adrift, over 4 minutes to play.
Well, can they invoke the spirit of those bronze medalists from BC Place back in 2020 here at the Singapore Sevens in the National Stadium? They're fighting, they're scrapping in these contact areas. But they do so nefariously, and South Africa come away with possession. Selvin David skips around on the arc, but he's picked up, wrapped up, held up.
Leave him, Red.
And he still manages to get the ball away. The guy has magic in his fingertips, but Canada have ambition and they're tossing it around nicely. They've got numbers as well. If they can find them on the left-hand side, into the hands of the Roadrunner. Ooh, dragged down at the crucial moment. David Richard, the first half try scorer.
Fantastic support from Alex Russell out wide to keep the play alive.
Lockie Kratz, the one unceremoniously dumped on his backside, but retained possession. South Africa so contestable at the breakdown. Was a small opportunity down the short side, but not enough. Not enough for Brock Webster to sneak away.
Yeah, Brock Webster thought he saw something on the short side, but he knew here. Maybe not the best decision, but really good play from Canada, backing each other. You see hands on heads and a few tired bodies out there. You're going to see some fresh legs in the form of Elias Ergas.
Thank you. We'll take our time.
He doesn't need much room to cause some damage. Real pace. And there's a bit of claret from the South Africans. That's kind of been the fierceness of this battle.
Yeah.
A lot of fresh legs coming on. DeVault Human. Zane Davids, Christy Grobbelaar. Zane Davids, wow, some player wearing number 4 for South Africa and only age 24 as well.
Thank you. Stop, no. Yeah.
A bit of warm up there for the men off the bench.
That's him receiving it there, then passing it back. He is built
with me here. Red.
Like a breeze block, Zane Davids. He's got some of the softest hands on the series, standing there in the lifting position at the front for this important line out for South Africa.
No, 2 and 2. Another one.
The best throw, but Canada doesn't compete.
So Pretorius takes it, and South Africa put boot to ball and ask Sheikh Soyuz Wapi to go chasing, and that he does. It sits up beautifully for him. Brilliant instinctive offload, knocked backwards as well, and South Africa are going to score through Darren Adonis. Well, two tries for the Adonis so far on the series, and this one came all from his hard work supporting his captain.
They've got so many ways to beat you, as we said. This one not super clean. Hergas does well to grab the short. And Adonis just pops up. Canada two stretch. The kick opened them up. That's a nice strike with the right boot. Adding the extras.
Salt into the Canadian wound. The try from Adonis maximized. South Africa leading Canada 19 points to 5. And they remain on the road to history. That 34 doesn't include this impending victory, but 1 minute and 40 seconds is a long time in rugby sevens. We're not writing these Canadians off just yet. They played with plenty of adventure, and they continue to do so until they're pickpocketed in the Singapore skies. And one thief you don't want getting his hands on the ball is Selvin Davids, because he will punish you.
Well, it looked for a moment like we might have an interesting last minute with that record on the line. But Selvin Davids said, no, I've had enough here. I'll have all of that ball. He's got it, and he's off, and he's scoring.
Well, Davids was looking around, and then he thought, do you know what? I'm just going to finish this myself.
Maybe not the most clinical of performances of this 35-match streak from Neil Powell's men. But a win nonetheless, and credit these young Canadian lads, they kept going.
And that is a quite brilliant touchline conversion as well. The toughest part of the field for a right footer.
Alex Russell just directing traffic there, a man from McGill University via Chichester in England. Just a few more subs.
To Sean Bowen coming on. The American football convert wearing one for Canada. The dying embers of this Pool A match. Punched low and hard towards the touchline. Canada turned and with one last chance to attack.
Loose in the middle, but Elias Hergas gets it back. No quit in the Canadian team. Good to see.
Well, that signals the end of the match. This will be the last play, and the man from Chichester is fouled.
Well, with the USA and Kenya, the other pool teams here, you never know with a late try what that could do at the end of day one when we account for points difference. The ball's been ripped out by South Africa. They're going to get an easy one here at the end. And as they started, they're going to finish with JC Pretorius.
Well, the meters were so hard to come by because of just how miserly the South African defense was. And JC Pretorius just does the rest and bookends a nice start to the Singapore Sevens for the Blitzbok.
Congratulations to Neil Powell and his men. Go past one of those famous New Zealand sides. Still got a few to make up for the big guns. I think it's 48 they're chasing. But job done here. It would have been on their minds for a few weeks, Joe.
So final score here. And it is South Africa who triumph over Canada 31 points to 5.